guys. I thought it'd be fun to just stroll down memory lane in the studio. It's come a long way. New viewers, this is the Tom Reefer Studio. Started with one 20-gallon mixed reef right here. This is a 20-gallon cube. And this is a 3.5-gallon Pico. I've shown you guys this before, but I thought it'd be nice to end out the year showing the three tanks to the new viewers if you're new. And the last one here is the 10-gallon. We're working on an experimental tank. Who knows what that's going to become. And this is my studio area. This is where I film. I got the curtain shut because it would be too much glare. There's the camera. Here's the coffee table where I drink my coffee and think of my ideas in this chair. And that's about it. This is the studio. This is a bed. It used to be a guest room, guys, but now it is completely my studio. So this is it. All right, guys. Last water change Wednesday before the new year. So I wanted to thank everybody who subscribed over the last year. My first video was December, I believe, and I put it in one at a time. What I do here is I pour it in areas. So it's been 1 year, and I want to really thank you guys a lot. I've had a lot of fun, and I'm in it for the long run. So hang in there, and you'll see some good videos coming up in 2021. Wow. So let's get right in. Oh, Water Change Wednesday. New viewers, it's question and answer format. You leave a question below the video. I'll answer it out there, and I'll answer it here. All right, so let's get into it. Water Change Wednesday, one last time for this year. David asks about keeping Montes and Acropora in a nano reef in a mixed reef tank. His concern is that SPS might require different parameters than soft corals and other corals in the tank. And I've always found that if you create an environment that's good for your SPS, it's really going to be good for everything else. You may not see the rapid growth that you would see in leathers and in soft corals because they're a little more dirty water coral, as I said in my other video. If you're keeping a low nutrient environment with phosphate and nitrate for your SPS, you'll still get good growth and good color from your soft corals. As you can see in my tank, I'm just happy that I've been able to keep alive the SPS in 20 gallons. It's been over a year now that I've had the SPS in the 20 gallon. The Monte, the Digitata, and the Posilopora, and the two Acros. So I'm just happy I've kept them alive. And what I'm doing is catering to that. I'm trying to keep a lower nitrate level and a lower phosphate level in the 20-gallon. More detail for you. So let's get right into it. The 20-gallon nano reef tank tour. I thought I'd start out with an evening shot of the tank here. This is about 7:30. Question. Parcool asks, if nitrates are higher, around 20 to 30 parts per million, will that have an algae issue? And guys, I have to say there's some reefers who keep their nitrates at that level and don't have any issue. A matter of fact, some swear by it, that if you keep them higher, you're going to have better growth. I just go by what my tank looks like. So if I begin to see algae growth, then I'll test and I'll see what my nitrate and phosphate is and make the correction from there. So I'm not correcting or reaching a number or doing anything until I see my tank change. So to answer his question, You can keep your reef tank at any parameter you want. If you're not seeing any hair algae growth or unwanted algae growth, then keep it as it is. Part of algae growth too, guys, is not just high nitrate. It could be your phosphate could be high. It's more predominantly phosphate that creates algae growth. So what I would recommend, Par, is don't be so concerned about the number. Be concerned about what your tank is looking like. So if you have algae growing, unwanted algae, then check your parameters and see what your phosphate is and see what your nitrate is and work from there. You can try lowering those to see if the algae goes away. I'm going to show you the steps to take to troubleshoot your problems in your aquarium. And this question is from Josh. He asks if the Hyger Mini Wave would be sufficient in a 20-gallon cube. And I said yes, as long as he has a decent return coming back into the tank from his return pump, and he'll have to turn the power up till its fullest power. Probably arrange it so he can get a counter current going through the tank. I told him I have an MP10 in my 20 in the back right corner, but I have that on the fourth setting, so it's less than 50%. So I know that the Hyger Mini Wave at 100% is at least what I'm using with the MP10, and that's working fine.
Guys, Tom here. I'm planning a 5-gallon nano reef build. I'm cooking the rocks here. So if you're interested, keep watching. 5-gallon unique shape to the aquarium. Cooking the rocks.
Broke Reefer Man 45 asked me how I'm going to get rid of the Aptasia in the 10-gallon. And I have a peppermint shrimp in the 20-gallon here. And they're a little slow to start, but once they get started, they'll keep them away forever. I had this over a year now, and I had some in there before I put the peppermint shrimp in. I put him in, about 2 weeks went by, nothing, and then suddenly they were gone. Then there's this Bergia nudibranch. I tried them once. They were difficult for me to keep them alive in my tank, and they disappear. They get lost, so you don't know if they're alive or dead. What happens with them is they only eat Aptasia. They're aquaculture just to eat those. So if you don't have a lot, they're gonna die right after they eat them all. They come really tiny. I've had great luck with the peppermint shrimp, and I would stick with that. Or one last thing you can use. I've used this on occasion by Red Sea, Aptasia X. It kills them, but what I found, if you're going to use this kind of stuff, I know there's other stuff out there too. If you're going to use that, it kills them for a time. They're going to grow back up again. I don't know about the t-shirt thing. I'm just not ready to sell stuff. All right, guys. That's got to be enough for the day before New Year's Eve, right? I agree. So listen, I wanted to say thanks again for your participation in the Tom Reefer channel. Let's keep the Tom Reefer train a-rolling. And new viewers, you might as well subscribe. We have fun here. I'm trying to do this like I would maybe in a classroom setting. I don't know, guys. I'm just doing what I'm doing. And obviously, some of you like it. So thanks again. Have a great new year. Don't drink too much. And I'll see you. When will I see you? Probably next Should I do one Sunday? All right, I'll do one Sunday. That'll be coming up after New Year's, 2021, Sunday's video. Take care now, guys. How do you guys put up with me, really? How do you put up with me? I know there's people that tune me out within seconds of seeing me. Now, who knows? It's interesting, isn't it, guys? You know, why we gravitate towards certain content creators and some we turn right off. You know, well, thanks for not turning me off. All right, guys. I'm going to walk through that door. The next time I come in, it's going to be 2021. Can you believe it? All right, take care now. See you in 2021.